Yeah, hello YouTube. So we have a shifted load here in Los Angeles, here in Chinatown, that I will need to correct. Cones for this. I'm gonna give you a bird's a view over here. A pallet of wood. Pretty much shifted over. I'll definitely try to expedite this process because I am blocking one of the lanes here. Luckily there's a center lane, so not too constrained, but we never really try to take a lot of time on these jobs. So the first thing is I'm gonna try to secure that pallet of wood there that is about to slip over. Secure it and then have the driver unhook his straps. I will lift it and pretty much place it on the floor down here and fix the bottom ones that caused it to slip in the first place. Utilize some thin straps. Let's see what I have. That's pretty thin. I might be able to use. Let's see the approximate weight. Did it go through?
Yeah, you ready?
Yeah. Got it. Thank you. Okay. That won't go through?
No, I mean it did, but I can't reach it.
Oh, I think I could reach it from here. Okay, got it. To protect my edges against this one. It's wood, but I'd rather protect the edge. Can you fit this one there? It fits all the way down at the bottom. You see, just slip it all the way down until. Do you need more slack?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do they bend?
Yeah, they bend.
Oh.
Yeah, stick them all the way down flat inside the crevice. Let me know if you need more space.
A little bit more, yeah.
Okay. Go ahead.
All right, there we go.
It went in?
I get one side in and the other side pops out.
Oh.
All right. There we go.
Got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, cool. Got them covered against the edges. Whew. It's two. Okay, you can go ahead and release them. Okay. So as it released it, obviously, my slings caught it, which is very important. And since it's equal, it's on equal sides, meaning it's perfectly balanced. It doesn't sway back and forth. I could also compensate that by obviously using two cables so I could control the how balanced it is. But it was pretty close, as the moment that he released it, it pretty much stabilized. Good?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, they are pretty heavy.
Yeah. Believe me, I tried to do it myself at first.
Right? Yeah, I just wanted to test it out. Oh, it's two of them. That's why.
Oh, yeah. We thought they were single units.
Yeah, no, I thought it was single. No, it's two of them. Okay.
All right.
No, it's easy then. Okay, I'll stick one strap through, and I'll move it over because that one's pretty flat. So by the time I pick up on this, uh-huh, I'll be able to shimmy it.
Okay.
I'll get another strap. We'll leave those there.
Okay.
That we can just be ready to go. Be able to stick this one through. Yep. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Can you just do me a favor and unhook those,
yeah,
please? Oh, down. Cool. Thank you. Cool. Perfect. Perfection. And this one you wanted to place it here, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's gonna stick out, but I'll flag it.
Okay. Just gotta make sure those covers are on. That way it doesn't tear the strap.
Yeah.
I'll do this one first. The opposite way?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there you go. So I normally put them all the way at the bottom because the straps tend to stretch about 15%.
Oh, okay.
So by the time it stretches, sometimes it pushes it out. Might fit right on the money, huh?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Good right there? Oh yeah, right on the money. How far do you have to go?
All the way to Pico. There's a Lowe's over there off kind of the borderline Santa Monica.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, it's not too far then.
Over there, yeah.
Nice.
It'll hold now.
Yeah.
It's over here on this side.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Nice and flat.
Yeah. So when I started, it looked like a dry van. It was all the way up. I shouldn't have left the yard this morning.
Yeah.
It was a bad load. And those Alveolos right here, they're very slippery. And the Home Depot guy, I tell him, just do the best you can, put it in the middle, because they don't have a lot of experience on the forklifts.
Oh, okay.
So, as soon as I made that turn, people I saw in the mirror. Like, yeah. We have a Moffitt too.
Okay.
You know, with the forklift in the back.
In the back.
He's all the way in Palm Springs.
Okay. So that happened. Normally you guys go and fix it yourselves,
yeah,
and stuff like that.
Yeah, we just fix it ourselves. Carrying loads like this, uneven, it happens a lot.
Yeah, I figured.
So we just fix it ourselves.
Yeah, uneven clamping, so it has room to slide. Yeah.
Has a lot of room to slide. So, I mean, I'll tie in it right now, and then by the time I'm driving, they'll start getting loose again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's true.
Everything's just constantly moving. It sucks.
Yeah,
I've been doing this for like 8 months, but with these guys in. Yeah. I retired for a year.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Okay.
I did 20 years in the operators union.
Oh, okay.
Took a year off, and my wife works from home, and I'm like, but I don't know. Maybe I should go back to the union.
Right.
Yeah. Do I got to sign anything?
No, you're good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I got paid already.
Okay.
All right. What's your name again?
Levi.
Levi. Nice to meet you, Levi.
Yeah.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
No problem.
I'll just get my cones and then take off. Thank you. I guess this guy has to go to Santa Monica. But the load's all fixed now. Just got to pick up my cones. Peace out.